what it do, y'all? It's your boy, Sherry Speech. Right now, I'm watching Supergirl, Season 3, Episode 3, Far From the Tree.
Excuse me?
And so far, you know, Kara and Sean went off to go to Mars because, if you remember, last week, Episode 2, Triggers. At the end of the episode, Sean received a message from Megan. You know, and now Maggie's telling Eliza about the last time she talked to her parents, when she was 15. Her dad was standing with a suitcase. They drove in silence, pretty much. And they stared off when you're done. Ice cream was on the trees. She was terrified. Terrified to say anything. Finally, I said, that was what I did. Looked at her with contempt and said, ashamed of me because she came on scared. So her dad dropped her off with the suitcase on the side of the road. That was the last thing her father said to her. So she hasn't seen or spoke to her parents since she was 15 when she spoke out and came out. So, oh wow, this is rough. This is gonna be rough. Okay, so Kara and Sean are on their way to Mars. Let's see how this goes. Hey y'all, what it do, y'all? It's your boy Sherry Speech. Right now I'm watching Supergirl, Season 3, Episode 3, Far From the Tree.
Excuse me?
And so far, you know, Kara and Sean went off to go to Mars because, if you remember, last week, Episode 2, Triggers. At the end of the episode, Sean received a message from Megan. You know, and now Maggie's telling Eliza about the last time she talked to her parents, when she was 15. Her dad was standing with a suitcase. They drove in silence, pretty much. They stared off when you're done. Ice cream was on the trees. She was terrified. Terrified to say anything. Finally, I said, that was what I did. Looked at her with contempt and said, you shamed me because she came on scared. So her dad dropped her off with the suitcase on the side of the road. That was the last thing her father said to her. So she hasn't seen or spoke to her parents since she was 15 when she spoke out and came out. So, oh wow, this is rough. This is going to be rough. Okay, so Kara and Sean are on their way to Mars. Let's see how this goes. Okay, so John, of course, doesn't believe that his father's alive. So his father got left behind. So pretty much what they're worried about is if John's father is captured, then they'll lead them to their resistance and obliterate them all. So they need John to convince his father to help them so they can save the White Martians together. Now mind you, just a little quick little recap. The Green and White Martians have had beef for centuries. So this is new. Okay, so Alice comes to Maggie and says, I never heard that story about you and your father. And Maggie said, you know, before that day, you know, he was the best father. I don't mean to make him sound like a fuck monster, but ever since that day, it's just been, you know, and Alex, like, have you thought about calling him, reaching out to him? She said, of course I have. But, momentary pressure in front of the house. They erased her from existence. That's messed up. And I said, and parents can do some really dumb stuff when they're up against something they don't understand. Invite them to the shower. Let's see how that goes. So, John C. finds his father. J. So you're the anger and bad thing for a band, you guys. You should be. So his father thinks that John, the actual John, is fake, used as a torture mechanism. He's been tortured for centuries. So John's like, father, it's me. It's me, John. I lived. I fled to Earth. I survived. He's still not believing it. So he thinks it's a white Martian. His father is not convinced that that's his actual son speaking to him. That's hurtful as hell, man. I can only imagine. Maggie just called her father. You know, to invite him to their wedding shower. She's wondering, like, why did I do that? Okay, so John is wondering why his father didn't recognize him. You know, everyone's like, well, he's been in prison for years. He's used to tricks, so why would he act like this? Now, too late. It's gonna